Ever since NVIDIA removed the support for 32-bit PhysX in RTX 50 series GPUs, which has their own issues to deal with, like supply shortages and barely any significant performance difference compared to the last one, I do want to check out the local Indonesian Balinese market to see what old NVIDIA GPUs that they are still selling that support 32-bit PhysX. Obviously, that's anything below the RTX 50 series GPUs, but I want to know how old I can get and how good the performance will be for the price. And boy, you do not disappoint, local market. The NVIDIA 210, not the GT 210, just 210, is quite literally the oldest and cheapest NVIDIA card I can buy in my local market for about 278,000 rupiah or $17.04. Please do not buy this card under any circumstances. This card is crap, even in 2009 when it was released, and it's even worse right now. The second cheapest NVIDIA card is the NVIDIA GT 610 at 318,000 rupiah or $19.50. While this card is a massive improvement over the 210, it's still a terrible card to buy for playing older games. It's crap in 2012 when it was released, and it's still terrible right now. The third cheapest NVIDIA card is the GT 730 for, honestly, I don't give a damn how cheap this goes. This is also a terrible card. Do not waste your money on this filth. And that leaves us to the fourth cheapest NVIDIA card, the GTX 750 Ti for 1 million rupiah or $61.31. This one, I can actually safely recommend. The 750 Ti is a real super budget king. If you want a super budget build to play older titles from the 2000s or the 2010s, the GTX 750 Ti for $61 is a hell of a good deal. For older titles of the 2000s and the 2010s, the GTX 750 Ti is the minimum that I recommend to people. And whatever you do, please do not get the GT 1030. That card is terrible and worse than the 750 Ti in almost every way.